December 4th, 2020 it is, and we're gonna do this winter swimming in a winterland, whatever you want to call this, or winter land. Let's try this.
Got snow shower now. Let's go from here. It's a little bit difficult to access the river from here. And so helps when you know where you put your foot on. It's quite chilly, December 4th. All 5 degrees. Weather outside is chilling. Na 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 na. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Na, 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 na. Whoa, it's a winter time. But the sun is so beautiful out there. It's just really beautiful. Try to do it this way. Actually, maybe I should have done it even. No. Can we do it this way? That way. Ugh. I waste a lot of energy on fixing this thing. It's not exactly very good stuff for me. Not very convenient at all.
Aye, aye, aye. Tough for me stuff to do. But that's what I'm gonna be using up there basically, and I'm gonna do some push-ups right here somewhere. And that's how that goes. That's basically the stuff I do. So I can access water again. Because you can imagine the temperature is not exactly warm. Yeah.
Is okay, but the hands, it's because of the video. This is swimming in the winter time, which method I was the one I figured out myself. I was not impressed with the stuff I've seen really on a YouTube, anything like that. So I decided to create stuff of my own. Please note that with the temperatures below 15, the danger of drowning is quite big. But yes, I reduced this by using a technique you are seeing right here. Basically, I go and what I do is I use this as a warm-up.
to enter the water with well blood well circulated, so I don't go just out there to drown basically. Basically, and so that was that. And then after a beautiful swim like this, go and see going. Basically, repeat the procedure. Again, for the round number two.
for the round number two, what I will do is probably go a little bit up and down the stairs to warm myself up, and then I'll come back and I'll do some more. I'm not in a really good shape, to be honest to you. I gained a lot of pounds. I'm not in a good shape. I need to get rid of this. This here started to grow. But this is like a perfect exercise to keep up in shape. Let's go with the round two. I am doing this because of my injury. Because of what was done to me in Poland. Basically, when I walk, I push like this. My spine this way so it doesn't go out. As a technique I have also developed. And when you go swimming, the cold icy water, what we'll do is what otherwise would probably inflate into injury, it would grow. It doesn't, and it doesn't so because the water is cold. So this is actually a therapy for a herniated disc. This, I assume, and it did help me tremendously a lot, is how you actually empower your spine after a severe injury like I got in Poland. This is how basically that stuff is done. It's a little bit difficult for me to film this. Still, I'm trying to give an idea what kind of situation I was left in. And the stuff I do to recover myself from it all. Let's do this again. It's tough for me to do this as I'm basically really doing myself not a favor right now. Doing this stuff, I'm really paying a price. It's actually much colder than what it otherwise should be. Atlanta, this is part number two. One more time, swim, and then I'm gone. Alright, so this is your winter swimming. It was very difficult for me today, and that was difficult because I did this movie like this. I did pay a tremendous price for it, and so I am really cold. I need to get lost from here now as fast as possible. And that was because of the camera. Otherwise, this is really, really enjoyable stuff. But the camera is filming. This did make things a little bit difficult for me. So I'm gonna have to be back actually to even collect that stuff, because it got really cold in my hands and in my foot, believe it or not. I am otherwise more dynamic, but other than that, this is just a pleasurable experience, and really, trust me, nothing more than that. This is a joy. I love it. I got used to it, and I do this to heal my spine, literally. So, this is a technique you would use for winter swimming. That means you do exercise, you get into the water, you do more exercise, and you get into the water again. If you would do some filming and stuff like this, then you actually risk freezing or something like that. Can't wait to get into the warm shower. Oh! Another thing I want to tell you about this business, how it goes. It's basically, it's like this, that if you, okay, once your temperature start to adjust itself back on a warm, say if you find yourself in a situation that you're frozen, the first thing you want to warm is down the spine, here down the spine. Let the hot water go down the spine
And this is basically how you overcome that shock when you go back to the warm. One shock you get when you got to the cold, another shock you get when you get back to the warm. And also, if you do some exercise, also when you get back to the warm, that also helps you. So there's quite a few things to get things easier to adjust the temperature to the warm back when you come from the cold and so on. So again, December the 4th, 2020.